planet?
Don't listen to his nonsense, Miss Barbara.
Okay. Well, basically, I found you lying outside the cathedral unconscious and used my elemental powers to heal you.
Paimon thinks you could still use a final splash of ice-cold water to the face.
That bard awakened first, but strangely, my healing powers had almost no effect on him. This is the first time I've encountered such a patient, but he just said, "It's completely normal," and then got up and left the cathedral.
He left? Already? Where'd he go?
The symbol of Mondstadt's hero. That's what he said. I wanted to stop him, but Jean... Master Jean said to let him leave. How strange.
Paimon remembers Venti healing under that tree before. It's probably due to the connection between Windrise and the animal Archon. Master Jean has figured it out as well, but we can't tell Barbara.
The Fadui were the ones who attacked you? That's too much. Master Jean has already returned to the Knight's headquarters. She said that she will look for evidence. But she also said that if the Fatui didn't leave any traces, the Knights might find it difficult to lodge a complaint against them.
Race you! May the animal Archon protect you.
Jules from Liyue.
Strange wanderer near Wolfenden.
Adventurers Guild. Nice to meet you.
didn't keep you waiting, did I? The wind amongst the branches is good. I love the way it smells. I said the exact same thing last time. Why do I only say these things when I'm down on my luck? So you noticed. This isn't something I'm meant to discuss with ordinary people. But I suppose I can let you in on the secret. As you know, visions are external magical foci that only a small minority of people possess. They use these visions to channel elemental power. In truth, every wielder of a vision is one who can attain godhood and ascend to Celestia. We call such people allogenes.
Allogenes? Paimon's never heard of them before.
That's because this is a secret that only Archons are privy to. We don't need primitive tools like visions. Instead, each Archon has an internal magical focus that resonates directly with Celestia itself, known as a gnosis. It's just a glowing glass ball I carry around to avoid suspicion.
So who was that nasty woman who sent Paimon flying and stole your gnosis?
Her name is Signora, number 8 of the Harbingers. She and the rest of the Harbingers have been given godlike executive authority by the Tsaritsa of Snezhnaya, and with it, strength surpassing that of other mortals.
The Tsaritsa of Snezhnaya? Isn't that...
Indeed. She is one of the 7. The Tsaritsa who reigns from her winter palace, and the one person that the Fatui Harbingers all answer to. The 7 don't always get along well, but still. I never thought that she would plot to steal another Archon's gnosis. How should I put this? 500 years ago, I knew her well. But I can't say the same is true now. You see, a certain catastrophe happened 500 years ago. And after that, she cut off all ties with me. But we can save discussion of the Cryo Archon and the Fatui for another day. If you seek the rest of the 7, many difficulties lie ahead of you still. You should head for Mondstadt's neighboring nation of Liyue. The Geo Archon who reigns there, unlike me, administrates his entire region personally. He only descends once every year to give his divine predictions, which set the direction for Liyue for the rest of that year.
Even so, it sounds like he works much harder than a certain someone, hmm?
In any case, this year's rite of descension is soon to begin. If you miss it, you'll just have to wait another year.
What? Oh, why didn't you tell us before? Well, then bye! We're going!
One moment, Windborn Outlander. Just use it gratefully. Or, better yet, treat me to a glass of dandelion wine. Traveler, as you set off on your journey once again, you must remember that the journey itself has meaning. The birds of Teyvat, the songs in the cities, the Tsaritsa, her Fatui and the monsters, they are all part of your journey. The destination is not everything. So before you reach the end, keep your eyes open. Use the chance to take in the world around you. Great. So, that's that for the Animo Archon's admonishments. Back to Venti time. If you want to chat, now's the time. A bard stays not always in a single climb. Up till the end, Dvalin remembered his duty as one of the Four Winds. As such, I don't intend to forcibly strip him of that duty and force my ideals of freedom onto him. I just hope that Dvalin will be able to choose for himself and understand what freedom is. Before I became an Archon, I too was taught the meaning of freedom in this way by a friend. If you want to chat, now's the time. A bard stays not always in a single climb. Kaya shared some new intelligence, you say? Oh, I see. So, the Abyss Order has a prince who orchestrated the plan to corrupt Dvalin? They were probably trying to turn Dvalin into a weapon of war for the Abyss. But that said, I have never heard of any such princess of the Abyss Order. I think so, too. Apparently. But how does a prince come out of nowhere and take command over the entire Abyss Order? If you want to chat, now's the time. A bard stays not always in a single climb.
That Fatui lady didn't hang around, did she? She just grabbed your gnosis and left?
She wanted to avoid any eyewitnesses from the Knights of Favonius. The slightest slip-up here would have destroyed the Fatui's diplomatic relations with the Knights.
So they're just gonna keep acting like Mondstadt's allies as if nothing happened?
If only the Seven Nations had banded together against the Abyss Order in the first place. The Fatui possess the strongest military among the Seven Nations, yet they've used it to steal the Holy Lyre, covet the power of gods, and use Dvalin as a bargaining chip against the Knights.
Speaking of the Lyre, didn't Diluc say something like this before? He said that the Fatui could only run amok across the Seven Nations and threaten the Knights because of the Harbingers.
Yes. As I said earlier, the Cryo Archon has given them authority and strength beyond that of other mortals. The Tsaritsa. I haven't seen her in 500 years. What is she thinking? What's her plan? Whatever the answer is, I have a feeling it's only going to make your search for the Seven all the more difficult. If you want to chat, now's the time. A bard stays not always in a single climb. As I said before, vision wielders are known as allogenes and may ascend to Celestia. A gnosis is a higher order nexus of elemental manipulation and is emblematic of an Archon's status as one of the Seven. But as for which of the Seven took your brother, I'm sorry, I don't know. Wait, as one of the Seven, I'm not clear of suspicion yet either, am I?
Hang on a hot second. Tone-deaf Bard is just one of Barbados' many incarnations. Who's to say that...
We're a great team indeed. Say, once you find your brother, how would you like to become one of the new Four Winds?
You don't seem too into it. Hey, Tone-deaf Bard! If being one of the Four Winds means free food, you can consider Paimon!
If you want to chat, now's the time. A bard stays not always in a single climb. Well then, best be off to Liyue. If the dissension ritual you failed to tally, then another year you must dally.
Right now, I wish I was sitting at the top of a tree, looking out over a meadow.
Oh, cider in hand.
some. People from Mondstadt hardly ever come here. Even though it's not so far away from the city, the environment here is totally untouched. It's a wild place ruled by the laws of nature. It's survival of the fittest out here. Even the slimes around here are huge. Like those super duper massive ones over there.
Do not worry. Wolves, friends. But you are?
We're just some boring old travelers passing through.
Don't smell boring. You smell familiar.
We smell?
You smell like Knights of Favonius. They are friends. I am Razor. I am no knight. My wolf pack. They are my family.
Your family?
Yes. They raised me. We live together. We are family.
So many questions.
They are angry with me. I help you. Exposed our ambush. Boar ran away.
Ah, don't worry. Paimon will get her friend to catch you another boar. He's stronger than he looks.
No, no need. When knights try to help, wolves go hungry.
Don't be silly. Wait here. We won't screw this up. Just watch.
thanks, but wolves catch 5 or 6 every hunt. Tonight they go hungry.
Oh.
Don't worry. You tried. At least you did better than other knight friend. The red one. Bernie girl. If she was here, whole mountain is fire. Can't catch even one boar. I must go now. Here is not safe. Careful. Always watching.
What a weirdo. Bernie girl? From the Knights of Favonius? What is he? Who do you think it is?